Welcome. It's wonderful to be with you once again. We'll be studying about the Holy Spirit, and we'll gain from what scriptures have to tell us about the facets of the Holy Spirit. I'd like to read for us from Isaiah chapter 11, verses 1 and 2. It says, "There shall come forth a rod from the stem of Jesse, and a branch shall grow out of his roots. The Spirit of the Lord shall rest upon him, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and of the fear of the Lord." So Jesus is being talked about here, and we're told that the Spirit of the Lord rests on him. If we recall, even in the New Testament, Jesus, he says that the Spirit of the Lord is upon me, and therefore God had anointed him to do several things. So the Spirit of the Lord anointed the Lord Jesus to do his ministry. The Holy Spirit is also known as the Spirit of the Lord. He is the Spirit of the Lord who is part of the Trinity. Now, he is the third person of the Trinity. And the Spirit of the Lord was present right at the beginning. Even at the time of creation, we see that the Spirit of God was hovering upon the waters. So there is a work that the Spirit does in creating. There is a work that the Spirit is able to do in bringing things to life. The Spirit of the Lord is the indwelling Spirit in a believer. When we become believers, scriptures tell us that we are regenerated, or we are recreated in our spirit man by the work of the Holy Spirit. So the Holy Spirit dwells on the inside of us. When Paul writes to the Corinthian church, he says that no one by the Holy Spirit can call Jesus accursed. So the Holy Spirit is here to glorify Jesus, and he dwells on the inside of us. And friends, I want to remind us today, as believers, we have this privilege of the Holy Spirit living so close to us. He is within us. He is in our spirit. And I can safely say that he's closer than our very breath. Now, what a comforting thought that the Spirit of the Lord is in our spirit. We are one spirit with him, scriptures say. So, because of this, every believer can live a life of partnership with the Holy Spirit, of relationship with the Holy Spirit, of communion with the Holy Spirit, and we don't have to ever feel that we are left alone. No wonder God says, "I will never leave you, I will never forsake you." What a privilege. The Holy Spirit is right within us, and he is the very Spirit of the Almighty God. We are the temple of this Most High God, and we must honor, we must walk in partnership with the Spirit of the Lord. Let's pray together. Heavenly Father, thank you for this privilege of being in us, God. Lord, we pray that we will always be aware of your presence, and God, that we will let you go before us in all things. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.